know, today I will be talking about my favorite stress buster. Any guesses what would be my favorite stress buster?
Toastmasters.
So let me give you some hints. It's totally free, okay? And you can do it anytime, anywhere, with anyone. Don't get me wrong, I'm not talking about something that is not allowed to be spoken in Toastmasters. I'm talking about very innocent thing which is very popular with all the ladies. But I bet that all the gents do it.
Gossips.
Wow, what a smart audience. There you go. A very warm good morning to the Toastmasters, judges and my dear friends. So, as a student, I love gossiping about my teachers. So when my teacher used to explain on the board, there is always an equal and opposite reaction for every action. Ma'am, I don't think that anything is going in my head. There is no reaction for your action. That's what I used to tell my friends, and all of them used to give a hearty laugh. And I was becoming like famous at gossiping, and I started kind of enjoying it. Till one fateful day, I was caught by my teacher, and I was sent straight out of the class. It was okay. I thought it actually aligned with my, you know, this gangster reputation that I had, prankster one who I always used to prank. But that day was really very fateful because my kid brother saw me standing out of the class and all hell broke loose. I tried to bribe him so that he doesn't go and tell it out to my family, but he didn't budge. And finally he went and declared that Didi was standing out of the class. And my mom and my relatives all questioned me. We all thought that you were an outstanding student and you turned out to be a standing out kind of a student. We didn't expect this from you. And I was heartbroken. It really pricked me. And I decided I will never gossip. Life went on and I had made strides in my career in different countries. It was only during my coach training that I got a very different perspective about gossiping. Now I want to ask you, how many of you think that gossiping is bad? Raise your hands. All of you think gossiping is good?
Okay.
Is there any way you think that we can turn gossiping into something very self-soothing and a self-healing experience? Raise your hands if you think we can do that. Great. Wow. That's right. Yeah, that's what I got to know in the coaching training, that if we cut out just two things from gossiping, that is hurting someone's emotions and focusing on the solution instead of problems, then even gossip can turn to be a very self-enriching experience. Taking cue from this, I thought that why not gossip today about my husband. So now, you would say, why do I have to gossip? But that also I attribute to the attention deficit generation. This is the alpha generation of today. If I would have told you that I would share insights about my husband, I don't think you would have listened, right? But if I say I would be gossiping about my husband, I know you will be all ears. Okay, so let me tell you why I married my husband. It was because my father and my elder brother were thoroughly convinced that he was a thorough gentleman. Though I had my own doubts about it. But it didn't matter. No, right? Yeah, that was the reason why I got married to my husband. And now this guy, he was working in a company for 5 years in Dubai. So in my mind, I had this figment of imagination where I was framing the scenario. I'm working in India in a very good company for 4 years. He's working there in 5 years. So what all I could say to pull him back here, why should I go to Dubai, you know? It would be like a tug of war, that's what I thought. So I was framing all of my reasons why I would pull him here. So this was in my figment of imagination, that the first point was, I told him, within 4 years of my working with this top-notch company, which everyone know about, I got 2 promotions and 2 on-site trips. What did you get? You were working in a small-time company in Dubai. And I don't think anyone even knows the name about it. So I tried to argue with him and I was framing all this in my mind. But when I raised this question to him, he told me, why do you even think that I would even think about moving? moving to India with you, it's obvious that you will move to Dubai like any Indian wife would do. Okay. Actually, I was becoming wife for the first time, so I had no idea that Indian wife would actually do anything. Okay. Then what happened? Fast forward to 12 years, my life in Dubai. I was happily settled. I was working in my dream job, in my dream company, and we were staying in the best of the communities. And all of a sudden, after pandemic, this guy decides that we will move to India. And he declared one day that I have decided that we'll move to India. And I repent. He said, why don't you just follow your husband's decision as would any Indian wife do? Amazing. Then I told him, okay, I thought, okay, this contest might be new to me. I slowly get adjusted to becoming an Indian wife. Later, I came to India and I told him I want to drive a bike. He said, why don't you drive a car? You always used to say in Dubai that the driving is your stress busting activity. I said, that was in Dubai. If I drive a car here, I will bust out of stress. That's not possible. I can't drive. So he said, leave your drama. Just drive like any Indian wife would do. Now, this was too much for me. He said, who are these Indian wives that you are looking at, first thing? And why are you even looking at them? So I could go on and on and on. But the point that I'm trying to make here is that I could take the liberty of gossiping about my husband today just because I know that none of you know him.